In this tutorial, we'll be discussing about wheel joint 2D. Let's take an example. Wheel joint 2D works best with car game objects. So I'll drag and drop a car game object onto the scene. I'll scale it down to say around 50. Now to this body of the car, I'll add a rigid body 2D and a polygon collider 2D. Let's keep it simple. I'll just edit this collider's wheel portion. Now I'll drag the wheel onto the scene. I'll resize it to around 30. I'll duplicate this wheel, move it to the right. Now to both these tires, I'll add a circle collider 2D. They look pretty alright. Now I'll add a wheel joint 2D. When I add the wheel joint 2D, it automatically adds the rigid body 2D component to both these tires. Now I don't want these wheels to be connected onto this point. I want them to be connected to the car. So what I do is I drag and drop the body of the car onto the connected rigid body slot. Now this is the point where both these wheels are connected. If I can zoom it a little bit. But I don't want the connection here. So I'll just rename these tires. This one to front. This one to back. So I'll take the front wheel. I'll untick this auto configure connect first. Doing so helps modify these anchor and connected anchor values. Now the anchor property is this one that's inside the wheel. This is the point where this wheel is going to rotate around. And the connected anchor is this blue dot. This is the point where this wheel will be connected to. So I'll move the connected anchor a little bit. Let's say I want it to be connected here. I'll copy the Y value, go to the back wheel and paste the Y value. So we have attached the wheel onto this car. Now we'll just run it as it is. Now you need to work around a little bit in order to get these wheels properly connected to this car. I changed the Y value to minus 0.83. You can actually think of this connected anchor as the axle. That's the point where it's going to be connected to the car. So I'll run it. So this is my car that has been set up. Now the first property that I would like to discuss is the enable collision property. When I tick the enable collision property, it will collide with the car and it would cause a hindrance in the movement of the car. So I'll just leave it unticked for the moment. The first property that I would like to discuss after enable collision is the motor property. Now in order to use this motor property, I'll have to tick this use motor checkbox. Now motor speed. Motor speed is the speed with which these wheels will rotate. You can think of it as the car's maximum speed. So I'll set that motor speed to around 100. And maximum motor force. So maximum motor force is the amount of force applied per fixed update in order to reach this motor speed. So I'll make that to say somewhere around 100. Let's run this project. You'll see that the car has started moving, but you can see that it's having a very funny motion. So this won't work. Let's look at some other properties now. I have selected both the back and the front wheel together so that I can edit the properties together. Now, next we look at is the suspension. In suspension, the first property is the frequency property. Now the frequency is how stiff you want these shocks to be. If you want it to have high stiffness, then you can raise its value, or if you want it to have less stiffness, then you can lower this value. The range is from 0 to 1 million. So in this case, I'll just turn on the frequency to say around 100. You'll see that now the shocks are pretty stiff, but it gets stopped by this obstacle. The next property is the damping ratio. Damping ratio is the amount of movement that you want from this wheel joint 2D. So when frequency decides how stiff the shocks are, the damping ratio decides how much movement it will get in that stiffness. So its value ranges from 0 to 1. Let's first set it to 1. It has become very stiff. You are not getting much movement from this wheel joint. So in order to understand this damping ratio better, I'll lower the frequency to say around 4 and I'll keep the damping ratio to around 0.1. Let's run it. You will see that it is getting good movement from that spring. The next property I would like to discuss is the angle property. Now if I'll zoom it a little bit, you can see a line that is going up and this one going to the right. So you can consider this to be 0 degrees and this to be 90 degrees. So the angle is the movement of the wheel. Currently it moves up and down. So if you want the movement to go a different direction, then you can change this angle. If I change it to 45, you can see that the direction of the line has become slanted. Now the wheel will bounce in this manner. So you may want to use it at some point of time, but currently I'll keep it back to 90. The next property I would like to discuss is the break force property. The break force is the amount of force that when applied to this joint makes it snap off from this joint. So currently it's set to infinity. I'll just apply it on the back wheel first. I'll set the break force to around 30 and I'll change the motor speed to around 500. You'll see that the joint breaks off from this car game object. So the force applied to it was higher than 30 and hence the wheel joint broke off. I'll set this back to infinity. Now the next property is the brake torque. Brake torque is the amount of torque that when applied to this wheel makes it snap off. That is the speed of the rotation when it increases to a certain point that we specify here. If it reaches that point, it snaps off from this wheel joint. So currently I'll set it to say around 20. You'll see that it snaps off from its attached game object. So these are all the properties of the wheel joint. I'll set it back to its original values. Let's play around a little bit. Let's increase the motor speed to say around 500. Let's run it. It's going pretty well. It's crossing all the obstacles. But will it be able to cross this one? Nah, it's not doing it. It's trying to cross over, but it's not able to. So what we can do in this case is, we can introduce a physics material that has a high amount of friction. So I have created a physics material named friction and I have kept its friction value to 0.9. I'll attach this friction material to the material slot in the rigid body 2D. Let's first try with the normal values. So you can see that it's trying to cross all, now let's run it. It's going well. So it's getting good traction now to move off from this point. So these are all the major properties of the wheel joint 2D. I hope you like this tutorial.
Make sure to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon so you get notified of the new video that I post here on YouTube. Thank you for watching.